Greetings to you all. In April 2024, I had a unique opportunity to visit the Science Museum IMAX in London while the GT projector was undergoing its semi-annual maintenance. During the maintenance, many of the projector parts were removed, so the internal components and mechanisms could be checked, adjusted, and repaired if needed. Since all these parts were absent, it was a great moment to have a look at the IMAX Rolling Loop and the path of film through the projector, which is usually hidden. For some reason, this video didn't perform as I expected, so I decided to freshen up my presentation and try once again, as I strongly believe that it's an exclusive look inside the most glorious movie projector ever created that will satisfy the curiosity of most cinema fans. Make sure to watch the entire video. At the end, I will explain how you can enter my giveaway for a chance to win one of these three stunning 70mm IMAX film strips. Just before we begin, I have one small request. Please consider subscribing, giving this video a like, leaving a comment, or hitting the notification bell. All of this helps the channel to reach a wider audience and allow me to keep making content like this. And if you'd like to support the Board Tech channel directly, you can use the Super Thanks feature here on YouTube, or consider becoming a patron on Patreon. All the links you need are in the video description below. Every 6 months, the IMAX GT projector undergoes a full maintenance procedure. The stakes are high. With sold-out screenings depending on flawless performance, nothing can be left to chance. Inside the projector are hundreds of moving parts, each one requiring a meticulous inspection. And it's not just mechanics. To service an IMAX projector, you also need to be part plumber, since critical components like the lamps and mirrors are water-cooled. As you can see, the lens and several side panels have already been removed. To show how the film threads through the machine, Matthew will take out a few more components: the upper deck output stator, the deck separator, what I like to call the remote finger, which forms the output loop, and finally the lower deck output stator. With the output side now fully stripped down, Matthew can walk us through how the legendary GT projector really works.
This is a slot in a rotor where we create the loop. There's air jets here, so when it's spinning around, as the loop is formed, it makes a little pop on the film. So to stop the film from stretching, a little air jet is there to cushion it. Then we have a segment of rotor here, which is a projector film. Then we have a shutter here, which is flickers the same image, and then the same image is shown again in this section. So one image flickered, and the same image is shown again before then. Next loop comes in, projected, flicker shuttered, projected again, next image comes in, same again, same again, same again.
I hope you're enjoying this real look inside the IMAX film projector. If you are, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, it really helps the channel. Now let's see what else Matthew has in store for us.
So we have our lenses already removed, so that's all we need to do for this. Taking the whole lens block apart is unnecessary for when we're doing servicing and cleaning, so we leave that on.
Next, Matthew moves onto the input side of the projector. Off comes the stator, the deck separator with cam unit still attached, and the base of the deck separator. The lower deck stator, however, will remain in place, so Matthew can lace a strip of film through it for demonstration purposes.
We've laced up the film, now it's locked into the gate. And in frame, we can now concentrate on creating the loop. So we dropped it in there, we close the input stator, and then we start to create the loop here. So I just push a little bit of excess film through here. And as long as I push enough, it will automatically make the loop. So I can put too little in and it won't make the loop properly, but I can push as much as I want in there. So as soon as it sort of misses the rotor there, and then we slowly start to turn it until a bit of a click there. So that click indicates to me that the air jet's taken off and our loop's locked in. And if you see along here a little bit further, this place here, that's where the film, the loop is starting to create for the next coming.
Okay.
So now I need to lock in the output side. So let me get my bearings. So yeah, we're gonna create the output loop now. Previously, like we said before, you have your remote finger. So now we've got that, everything's removed. I can actually get my hand in here, just like in the input side. So now I'm just going to frame it up. So look, we're looking at about with no loop, it's about three perforations. So I'm just creating a loop which is three perforations big until my frame line is there to say I'm in sync. And again, it's important that whilst this isn't going on screen afterwards, it needs to be, the loop needs to be the correct size, because if it's too big or too small, it's going to cause issues and damage potentially as it comes out of the projector. So there's a loop we just created a minute ago. And if we keep an eye on this cam arm and the loop, as it goes and enters into the block here, the lens block, the cam arm starts to engage now. Can you see it just starts to move and it goes and catches the film and to decelerate it. Now we're projecting the image that is now holding the film still. So this part of the film is not moving anymore. And as it comes here, as you see, the loop's starting to build. As soon as we start to turn this, that loop builds. That little click is the air jet. It's not on at the moment, so it'll be a different sound, but that's the air jet going. Then it comes through, builds the whole loop, and the same thing happens again. As it enters there, that starts to move. Can you see how I rock it backwards and forwards? I'll make it really distinct for you guys. Yep. There we go. Now if I do it slowly, it catches, decelerates, builds. Comes out as a full, and dissipates.
That concludes the IMAX Rolling Loop demonstration. As a bonus, Matthew also removes the front panel, revealing the two 15,000 watt xenon arc lamps and the mirrors that direct their light into the lens. These lamps generate an incredible amount of heat, which is why both anode and the cathode are water-cooled. Even the mirrors blasted by those intense beams require water cooling. This has been a rare chance to peek inside the legendary IMAX Grand Theater projector. I'd love to know what you think, so share your thoughts in the comments below. Before I wrap up, I have an exciting giveaway for my viewers. If you'd like to receive one of these three 70mm IMAX film strips, just leave a comment below saying, "I want a 70mm IMAX film strip." I'll send one out to three lucky winners. That's it for this video. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you again soon.